Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, the leader in e-commerce accounting. Today we're going to talk about Xero conversions. And specifically, this video is inspired by my buddy Brian, who has asked me a couple of times, how do we decide when we're going to convert a file from QuickBooks Online to Xero, or when we're just going to start over from scratch? So that's what this video is going to be about. I want you to stick around to the end because I have my favorite trick of all time. I was literally high-fiving myself at my desk when I like figured this out. I like ran downstairs and was like, Scott, I just figured out this super cool trick. And he was like, wow, that's real exciting, Patti. But it's really cool. Any accountants who are watching this are going to be really excited. So, all right. So let's get started. All right. So way back in the day, I started out using the free conversion that Xero offers, converting from QuickBooks Desktop to Xero. And honestly, it worked pretty well. There are a lot of hoops you have to jump through and make sure that this T is crossed and that I is dotted, but it did work really well. The one thing that I did not like about it is there was something funky about the customer and the vendor information, how that was pulled in. So like when you looked at like your checking account after you had converted the file, if there was a payment on any of the invoices, whether it was a sales invoice or a purchases invoice, it wouldn't tell you exactly who it was that the invoice payment was paid to or from, which was really kind of annoying. The accounting was all right, but I didn't like that. It just really bugged me. It wasn't as clean as I would have hoped it would be. So after a couple of years of that, we moved on to trying this service called MMC Convert. Now, this is not a paid advertisement, but I do love these guys. They do really quality work. I've never heard anything bad about them from any of the other accountants that I know who have used them. They do a really quick job. It'll take 3 or 4 days to convert the whole file, but it's really quality work. I've never had any problems with them. They still have a list of things that you want to make sure you do to make sure that everything runs smoothly, but it's really a great experience. Then somewhere in around 2016, I just kind of realized that everybody's books were, they were a train wreck. And it was so much harder to go through and clean up their mess than it was just to start over from scratch. Because one of the best things about Xero is that it makes data manipulation really quick and easy. So we just stopped using the conversion process altogether. We just start over from scratch. And we let the clients decide how far back in time they want to go. If they really do want all that historical information, which most times they don't, we'll go ahead and convert the file through MMC Convert. But otherwise, we'll just pick a new date and time to start and just clean it up going forward. Now, here is where my badass trick, this is the badassiest trick of all time, okay? So, and I'm going to show you how to do it. What we're going to do, and the reason why we do this is because when you pull in all the information from the bank and the credit card and the loan, you have all of the transactions, but sometimes there's details in QuickBooks Online that you want to keep, or in QuickBooks Desktop or wherever. There's information that you want to keep. It's good quality information. People have done memos, or there's like context and stuff that you don't want to lose. And so that's what we're trying to do, is we're trying to retain all that information in this new file. So we're going to go log into a QuickBooks file, actually a QuickBooks Online file, and we're going to go down to a credit card. So this is going to be the information that you want to now live in Xero. Okay. You make sure that you have the date range of the information that you want, and you'll see that it has all the different vendor names, it has all of the amounts, it has all the coding and everything. If there were any descriptions and things like that, it would live in here too. Then you just go up to the top and you export this to Excel. It is going to download an Excel file for you that has all the information in it that you need. Okay, so I'm going to make all the data look exactly the way I want it to look. Please go check out this video here, the top 5 coolest tips in using Xero. Look for tip number 1 that's going to show you how to automatically import reconciled transactions into Xero. And that's going to show you exactly what I'm doing here. And then I'll meet you over in Xero. Okay, now I have the whole file the way I want it. I've added an account code, a tax code. I actually changed the signs on these so that it would import properly. And I'm going to import that into Xero. So we're going to go over here to this account. We're going to manually import this statement. So again, these are the transactions that came from QuickBooks Online. I'm going to assign it. Okay. So all of these have been assigned, and we're going to go ahead and import it. You'll notice that 120 were imported, no duplicates, everything was directly reconciled. Okay? So now that all these transactions are in here, you're like, yay, okay. But wait, they're all reconciled. So how does this get me closer to where I want to be? So here's the thing. It could be that the file that we were using before is complete garbage, and there could be duplicates in here. There could be missing transactions. So we need to actually reconcile this against the bank. Now, the problem we have is that all these transactions are showing up as reconciled. This is where the bad assery comes in. Okay, so we go over to the bank statements. And we're going to actually select all of these transactions. Actually, let's get all of them. So we're going to select all these transactions, and we are going to delete the bank statement lines. Now, do not panic. This is okay. It'll be fine. Watch what happens. We're going to delete all of these transactions, but we're only deleting the bank statement parts. The account transactions themselves, if you look in here, are still in here. See? They're just showing up as unreconciled. So all of those notes, all the amounts, all the payees, all that other information is in here. So now all we do is we connect it to the actual bank account, pull in the bank feed, and then we reconcile against them. So let me show you what that looks like. Okay, so I've imported the bank statement information. So this came actually from the bank, whereas the other transactions came from QuickBooks Online. And you'll see they all match up. So if you see lots of green here, it means that the prior accountants did a really good job. And we're going to go through and just kind of make sure that this is all cool. Okay, so I'm going through, okay, 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 and look, there was an extra transaction here that wasn't recorded in the books. So this is telling you that the books that you had before weren't quite cool. Either that or the credit card has a mistake, but it's more likely that the books weren't right. So we can include that. And then I'm going to keep reconciling. Okay, so now we've reconciled everything, but look, there's a discrepancy. So if you go to the reconciliation report, it'll show you that, oh, there was one other transaction on here that did not come through the bank, so this was not recorded properly. It'll show up as unreconciled, and when you go to match it against the bank and you look at the actual physical bank statement, you'll see that this probably doesn't belong here. So you just remove and redo that, and boom, all the transactions that were previously in QuickBooks Online are now in here, and it really did not take very long at all. And it came in really cleanly, and it's going to all the accounts that you are telling it to go to. So this can save you all kinds of time and all kinds of brain damage, and it works really slick. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please like, comment, share. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and I'll catch you later.